O Lord, open my lips.
Will those asking for admission to the novitiate please come forward? Mr. Liam Helms?
Present.
Mr. Caleb Whitlock?
Present.
What is it you seek?
The mercy of God and fellowship in this community.
May the Lord bring to perfection the good he has begun in you, and may our divine master furnish us all with his light. Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. During the time young Samuel was minister to the Lord under Eli, the word of the Lord was scarce and vision infrequent. One day, Eli was asleep in his usual place. His eyes had lately grown so weak that he could not see. The lamp of God was not yet extinguished, and Samuel was sleeping in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was. The Lord called to Samuel, who answered, "Here I am." He ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, you called me." "I did not call you," Eli answered. "Go back to sleep." So he went back to sleep. Again, the Lord called Samuel, who rose and went to Eli. "Here I am," he said, "you called me." But he answered, "I did not call you, my son. Go back to sleep." Samuel did not yet recognize the Lord, since the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again for the third time. Getting up and going to Eli, he said, "Here I am, you called me." Then Eli understood that the Lord was calling the youth. So he said to Samuel, "Go to sleep, and if you are called, reply. Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening." When Samuel went to sleep in his place, the Lord came and stood there, calling out as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel answered, "Speak, for your servant is listening."
Thank you. Brothers, may I just offer a very short reflection this morning, especially you, Liam, and you, Caleb, who join us. We've probably all heard many definitions of what is a monk. I'll leave that to you and to your reading and to your own thoughts. But I think the best definition of what is a monk is a monk is a person who every day asks himself, what is a monk? A monk is a person who every day and at every moment seeks an answer to that question and seeks to live it out. I offer that to you, my brothers. I offer that to you, Liam and Caleb, that in the next year of novitiate, you in particular will be asked every day to ask yourself, what is a monk and how can I be one today in this moment at this circumstance?
My dear brothers in Christ, we recognize your desire to undertake the Benedictine way of life. But as the apostle says, test the spirits to see whether they are from God. For this reason, the Holy Rule tells us that newcomers to the monastic life should not be granted an easy admittance. We must first determine whether you truly seek God and whether you are eager for the work of God, for obedience and the practice of humble service. We must also tell you all the trials and hardships through which we make our journey to God. And so I ask you, are you willing to live in our community and begin to seek God as a novice in the monastic way of life?
I do.
May the Lord bring to perfection the good he has begun in you. Amen. My brothers, are you willing to accept these men as novices in our community? Having heard the consent of our community, I accept you as novices for the monastic way of life. Let us pray. God, it is you who calls us to serve you and all our brothers and sisters. Hear our prayers and bless these brothers who wish to undertake our way of life. Help them to know your holy will and strengthen us all in your service. We ask this through Christ our Lord. so that you may be reminded daily that you have taken on a new way of life. I give you the following name of a saint by which you shall be called. May you always be conscious of the virtues of this saint. May they lead you to the day of your profession and guide you to your heavenly goal. Liam, you shall be known as Brother John Fisher. Caleb, you shall be known as Brother Aylred. In chapter 58 of the Holy Rule, St. Benedict says that a senior chosen for his skills in winning souls should be appointed to look after those who enter the novitiate with careful attention. I entrust your formation in the monastic way of life to the care of Brother Albert Garr, our novice master, who now presents you with the rule of our Holy Father, St. Benedict. Receive the rule of our most holy Father, Benedict, which sanctified those who have gone before us in the monastic way of life. Read it and study it. Embrace its guidance with hope and confidence, and cherish Christ above all, and pray for the grace that you may know what you are undertaking in this community. By God's grace, may you prefer nothing whatever to Christ, and may he bring us all together to everlasting life. Amen.